Let's face it, we're all worried about Disney's animated fairy tales, especially with their apparently permanent switch to computer animation from hand-drawn animation, at least for features. But while we wait on pins and needles for Frozen, a flick that seems to skew awfully young, Disney is reaching out to its older fans with several live-action fairy tales. Yes, while Snow White, The Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, and more have captivated generation after generation, none have joined the billion-dollar club, while Tim Burton's live-action Alice in Wonderland has. In fact, it was one of the first members of the Billion Dollar Club. So while Toy Story 3 remains Disney's only animated entry in the hallowed group, when it comes to live action, they've got five, more than any other studio. So with their Marvel and Pirates movies already locked in and Star Wars Episode 7 sure to join, why shouldn't Disney make their domination even more complete with a live action fairy tale brand? Now sure, Oz fell way short, not even reaching half a billion, but Disney has high hopes for what they've got up their magic wand. First up in 2014 is Maleficent, and Angelina Jolie was the marquee attraction at their D23 Expo. Due to health issues, Jolie has been absent from the silver screen since her doubleheader in 2010, but this is arguably the role she was born to play. Production designer turned director Robert Stromberg has a real tightrope to walk here, having to find the right balance between Tinkerbell and Mommy Dearest. Remember, Maleficent is an evil fairy, and apparently this movie will not only show the story of Sleeping Beauty from her side, but will be an origin story to boot. But footage shown at D23 did apparently include a live-action version of the classic scene from the 1959 animated version where Maleficent crashes Princess Aurora's magical christening. As I've said before, I'm keen to see Jolie in the role, but not if it removes most of Maleficent's fire. Also, it is one tall order to replicate the deliciously evil line readings done by Eleanor Audley in the original. Cate Blanchett has the same hurdle in front of her as she's recreating another classic Audley role, Cinderella's evil stepmother. In 2015, the director of Thor, aka Kenneth Branagh, will bring you a darker version of Disney's most popular princess, at least according to merchandise sales. And speaking of merchandise sales, considering how lucrative the Disney Princess line is currently, imagine what a Disney Princess line for adult women based off of live-action movies could do. After a huge casting search, Downton Abbey's Lily James won the coveted role of Cinderella, while Game of Thrones' Richard Madden is playing the prince. Helena Bonham Carter will play what I'm guessing is a surprisingly dirty-looking fairy godmother, while Holiday Grainger and Sophie McSherrill will play the evil stepsisters. Now I have to admit, I too find it hard to resist anything with a Disney princess on it, but I don't think I would have chosen Cinderella as the first princess to go live action. That's largely because when I recently revisited the animated film as an adult and watched Cinderella count mice and birds as her only friends before voluntarily serving as a maid in her own house, well, it seemed to me she'd gone nuts. So unless that's the direction they're going in, I think the story might be a tough sell. Mulan would have been a much better choice, as that film always seemed partially held back to me by its all-ages appeal. Plus, hello, Asian audiences have money to burn right now. Finally, smack in the middle between Maleficent and Cinderella, Disney literally has the kitchen sink with Into the Woods. Think Once Upon a Time, but with singing. Oh boy! Johnny Depp once again dances for the mouse as the big bad wolf, while Meryl Streep plays the witch. Anna Kendrick is also signed on and rumored to be playing Cinderella, and will be joined by Emily Blunt, my guess is, as the baker's wife, and most likely as Jack, Chris Pine. He can sing? Who cares? Although, no matter how amazing a cast they put together, it's worth noting that Into the Woods is one of those musicals that never really quite caught on. Plus, while Rob Marshall did a dandy job with Pirates 4, members of A Geisha and 9 were a mess. Then again at Christmas, when Into the Woods is slated to hit theaters, who isn't going to be in the mood to see all their favorite actors playing their favorite fairy tale characters singing one big happy song? So what do you think of Disney's live action plans? As good or better than their animated fairy tales? And does any other studio have even a chance of breaking into the Billion Dollar Club on the same scale? Write your thoughts down below. I'm Grace Randolph and this has been a Movie Bite. You can watch more right now.